Hi, welcome to automationtesting.in. Please hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get the notifications. In this video, we will see how to find duplicate characters count in a string in C#. So this is one of the important interview questions in C#. So first we'll see what is the requirement. So I have given a string called Krishna Sakinala. Inside that, I want to find the duplicate characters count. So how many times K is repeating in this entire string? How many times R is repeating? How many times I is repeating? Something like that. So here the output is A 4 times, S 2 times, I 2 times, K 2 times and N 2 times. So this is what I want to print. Okay. So for that, we need to build a logic. So first we'll go to Rider. So here I'll create a class add class. So find duplicate characters count in string. So I have created a class. Now I'll find duplicate characters. I'm creating a method. Okay. So here first I'll take one string where str equals to Krishna Sakinala. So I have taken this string and then first, I need to convert this into characters, right? K, R, I, S, H, N, A, S, A, K, I, N, A, L, A. So first I need to split this character string into character. So, and I'll store in a character array. So now, how many times K is repeating? One time and here two times. So I want to get that. So first what I'll take a characters array where chars is equals str dot to char array. Okay. So now I converted that string into characters array. So and I'll take another one is dictionary. So dictionary will hold values in the form of key value pairs, right? So here I'll take dictionary and char comma integer and then char map is equals to new dictionary. Okay. So here the logic, first I'll tell you the logic. What I'll do inside this characters are inserted as keys. This is key value pair and the respective count inserted as values. Okay. So then after that, if the dictionary already contains the character, then increase its value by 1. Okay. So what I'm doing, I'm storing these things inside this k as character and the respective occurrence as integer. Okay. K one time, r one time, I one time, something like that. And if dictionary already contains the character, means the key already. So K contains one time. When it comes here, if it is already contains, K already contains in the map. So it already contains K. If contains K, then increase that value by 1. Previously this value is 1. If the second time it is occurring, then increase the value by 2. So we need to build that logic. So then how? It will become k comma 2 and then r comma 1 and then I comma 2, something like this. It will create the dictionary. Okay, now I will loop through this character array and I'll build the logic. So I'll take for each where ch in chars. Okay, I'm looping through each and every character from this chars and I'm building the logic here. If that dictionary, okay, so I'll say instead of map character dictionary, okay, if the character dictionary dot, you see that contains key, contains values. So I'm interested in keys. Already we discussed that keys are the each character. So means contains key means that contains character. What is that? Ch. If it contains that character, this dictionary keys means K, R, I, these are all keys. 2, 1, 2, these are all values. So if the dictionary contains the key means one by one it is looping through, right? K, R, I, S, something like that. First time it will come K. Second time 2, R. Third time I. Something like that. It will loop each and every character. While looping through, I am just, verifying whether the key means that character already contains in the dictionary. Then what I need to do? Char dictionary of that character I will increase. Char dictionary of ch plus 1. Okay, I'll increase the particular value. So char dictionary of ch means of ch means of k, then it will give me the value. What is that? 2. Okay, first time it will be 1, right? First time it will be 1. So char dictionary of k is equals to already contains 1 plus 1, that will become 2. So that is the reason k 2 times. If it is not containing, then I'll write the logic inside the else block. What I'll do? Char map means char dictionary dot add. What I'll add? Ch comma 1. So it will be 1. If it is not repeating, then I'm adding that character value as 1. If it is repeated, then I'm increasing that value. Okay, this is the logic. So now the map became something like this: k comma 2, r comma 1, I comma 2, a comma 4, s comma 2, something like that. Now I need to loop through this map again, means this dictionary again. So loop through the dictionary for only keys, right? I'm interested in keys. K, R, I, S, something like that I need to loop through. Here also I'll take for each loop, and the same way where ch in where. So before that, what I need to do? I'll create a hash set where keys is equals to new hash set. Why hash set? Set will contains only unique keys. So I need unique keys, K, R, I. So I'll take unique keys and I'll loop through these keys. Okay, so unique keys. Now what I'll do? If char dictionary of ch is greater than 1. Okay, if it is greater than 1, then what we need to do? We need to print those occurrences, means values. So then I'll say console dot write line dollar character ch I say repeating what, how many times? Char dictionary of ch, okay, times, right? So I'm taking unique keys, and then unique keys I'm looping through char dictionary of ch. Char dictionary of ch is k, means what is the value of that? 2 greater than 1. Okay, if it is 2 greater than 1, I am going inside this, I am printing character k repeating 2 times. If second time is r value is 1 not greater than 1 equal to 1, so this if condition fails, so it will not go inside this and it will not print that r related information. Okay, so then only the values which is having greater than 1 only will be printed in the console. Okay, so the logic is done. What we have done, I have taken one string and converted into character array, and I have taken one dictionary and I'm storing key value pairs as these characters and respective occurrences, and I'm looping through. If the dictionary contains already that key, then increasing that value by 1. If it is not, then I'm putting as 1. Once I get this dictionary, I'm looping through only keys. If the key's respective value is greater than 1, then I'm going inside that and I'm printing that particular character and occurrences. Okay, so now I'll go to the main program and I'll call this. So in the main program, not find duplicate characters. Okay, find duplicate characters count in string. This is a class. Inside that, this is a static method I'm calling. Now I'll simply run this. So it is not printing. I think we need to write after completion of this for loop console dot read key. Okay, console dot read key, then I'll execute again. I think this time it will print. Still not printing. Give me 1 second. Sorry, I did a mistake here. That so when you come, I am getting only keys. From where I am getting keys? I need to mention this. The important thing I forgot. So what is that? Char dictionary dot keys. Right. I want to store keys. Right. From where I'll get char dictionary dot keys, that I'm storing in the keys. So I forgot to give this one. So now we'll run again. You see that character k repeating 2 times, character I repeating 2 times, character s repeating 2 times, character n repeating 2 times, character a repeating 4 times. So it is giving me the values. So I'm not very sure. I'll comment this and we'll see whether it will print or not. Now it is printing. So this one not needed. Now what I'll do, I'll change this string. I'll give Krishna Kumar Sakinal. So this time, if I run this, you see that here space character space repeating two times, right? There is a space between Krishna Kumar and Kumar Sakinala. So this space. So space also considered as a character. That is the reason it is giving me space also. And A repeating 5 times, K repeating 3 times. It is updated, right? And if you do not want to print spaces, you just remove the spaces, then run the logic, right? So if you want spaces, then execute as it is. Okay, this is how you can find the duplicate characters in a given string in C#. Okay, that's all in this video. Thank you.